Olá pessoal, welcome back to the Sounds of Portuguese. My name is Adelina and in this video we're going to learn how to tell the time in Portuguese. Bora lá! First, let me explain three key things about telling time in Portuguese. The first one is we use the 24-hour clock in Portuguese, mostly in written Portuguese. The second thing is that we always refer to the time in the plural except for 1 o'clock, midday and midnight. And the third thing is that we actually don't say AM or PM. Let's look at some common sentences for asking time in Portuguese. So, because we refer to the time in the plural, we also ask for the time in the plural and we say Que horas são? What hours are they? Que horas são? Que horas são? Que horas são? Now let me talk about the pronunciation of que horas são. Que glues into horas because the H is silent. So que horas, and that U changes to a small, slightly E sound. Que horas, que horas. And the S from horas glues onto the S from são. Que horas são? Que horas são? Que horas são? Now let's look at another one. Sabe que horas são? Sabe que horas são? Sabe que horas são? So the pronunciation of this one is similar to the first one. The que horas são is the same, but this one has sabe at the beginning, and most of the time that final E is not going to be overly pronounced in Portugal. So sabe que horas são? Sabe que horas são? These final E's are very similar to final E's in English, like in the words make and take or bake. We don't say bake or bake hay or like hay and so forth. So, sabe. Sabe que horas são? Let's look at the next one. Pode-me dizer as horas, por favor? Pode-me dizer as horas, por favor? Pode-me dizer as horas, por favor? So, with the pronunciation of this one, a few things are happening. So, the E in pod, just like the E in sab, is suppressed. So, it's like falling away from the word. So, we pronounce it pod and pode-me, so can you to me. Pode-me dizer as horas, por favor? Because the H is silent, that S from as changes from a sh to a z, because the S is now as if it were in between two vowels, like in the words casa and mesa. So we link it by doing the same thing. As horas becomes as horas. Pode-me dizer as horas, por favor? And if you'd like to add a layer of courtesy to this, you can use what is commonly known as the imperfeito de cortesia. And instead of saying pods, you put it into the imperfeito. So podia. Podia-me dizer as horas, por favor? Now, if you're wondering, could you use faz favor or se faz favor? Yes, you absolutely can. I have a free lesson on my blog about this topic, and I also discuss this in this video over here. So we answer in the same way. We say são, they are, followed by the hours. So for instance, if it's 4 o'clock, we would say são 4 horas. São 4 horas. If the conversation is a bit more formal, or if it's in written Portuguese, this will be 16 hours. And we represent the hours with a little H. So, são 16 horas. São 16 horas. São 4 horas. São 4 horas. So you might have noticed that we're using the verb ser in the form of são, they are, instead of estar, even though time ticks onwards. For those of you who know me, you know that I dislike the temporary versus permanent description because it doesn't tell the full story. We're using ser because we're describing a what, and the estar typically describes a where or a how. So we don't say where time is it, and we're not saying how time is it, we say what time is it. And therefore it is ser. it's 4 o'clock, therefore it's always 4 o'clock every day at 4 o'clock. And that's the logic behind it. It's a what and not a how or a where. I've said that we refer to the time in the plural except for three exceptions, and that's when it's 1 o'clock, midday, or midnight. If it's 1 o'clock, you would say, è una ora, è una ora. And if it's midday, you would say, è mezzodia, è mezzodia. And if it's midnight, è meia-noite, é meia-noite. Que horas são? É meio-dia. Que horas são? É meia-noite. Que horas são? É uma hora. If you noticed, I said uma instead of u. This is because the word hour is feminine in Portuguese, so it's actually not correct to say é uma hora. But if you did, it's not the end of the world. People will understand what you mean because the context is there. É uma hora, but people will understand é uma hora. This also happens with the number two, so we have a masculine two, dois, and a feminine two, duas. So if it's 2 o'clock, you would say são duas horas and not são dois horas. This only happens with the numbers one and two, and all the other numbers that have a one and two in it, like 21, 22, 101, and 102. These will have masculine and feminine, and the hundreds as well. So a number like 200 is duzentos, will have a feminine counterpart, duzentas, and the same for all the hundreds. Those are the only numbers in which this happens, but if you're normally regularly counting, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we always go with the masculine versions. This is why you hear things like queria dois cafés, or queria duas cervejas. But what happens when we want to say AM or PM? In Portuguese, we explicitly refer to the section of the day. So if something is in the AM hours, we say da manhã. Da manhã. And here's a pro tip for my more advanced students. If you really want to impress the locals, you can say da madrugada when you're referring to the wee hours of the night. So these are the hours between midnight and before sunrise. So for instance, instead of saying 3 da manhã, you could say 3 da madrugada. And if it's in the afternoon, we say da tarde. Da tarde. And if it's in the evening or in the nighttime, we say da noite. Da noite. So evening sometimes can still be tarde, or it can be noite. So if it's late afternoon, early evening, you could still say tarde, da tarde. And if it's late evening, nighttime, that's when you start saying da noite, da noite. People often get confused with de manhã and da manhã. That's a great question. De manhã just means in the morning, and da manhã means AM. So the difference is going to be, if something is happening in the morning, is going to be de manhã. For example, eu vou trabalhar de manhã. Eu vou trabalhar de manhã. But da manhã will always be attached to an hour, a specific time. So I could say, vou trabalhar às 9 da manhã. And of course, here it means AM. At 9 a.m. I go to work. The question for asking at what time something is happening at is a que horas? A que horas? And we link it a que horas. So similarly to que horas são, we have the same que sound change here. This que, this e changes to this e. A que horas? A que horas? For example, at what time do you start work, or at what time do you go to work? A que horas começas a trabalhar? A que horas começas a trabalhar? A que horas vais trabalhar? A que horas vais trabalhar? If you want to say at a particular hour something is happening, the word is às. And this is a contraction between at and the. Because we refer to the hours in the plural, if it's a plural amount of hours, then it's going to be ash, ash. So if I'm working at 2 in the afternoon, vou trabalhar às 2 da tarde. Vou trabalhar às 2 da tarde. Something happening at 9 p.m. would be às 9 da noite. Às 9 da noite. Something happening at midnight is going to be singular, so now the at is à. À meia-noite. The same for 1 o'clock. À uma hora da tarde or à uma hora da manhã. À uma da manhã. There is one exception to all of this, which is noon or midday. Because it's masculine, the at changes to ao. Ao meio-dia. Vou para casa ao meio-dia. I go home at noon or midday. So that was the hours. What about the minutes? So a quarter of an hour is quarto de hora. Quarto de hora. Half an hour is meia hora. Meia hora. In English, we also use the words past and to. So many minutes past the hour and so many minutes to the next hour. But in Portuguese, you can just use the and, separating the hours from the minutes, all the way up to the next hour. So if it's 3:15 or a quarter past 3, we would say são 3:15. São 3:15 or são 3:15. São 3:15. Likewise, if it's 3:30 or half past 3, you can say são 3:30. São 3:30 or são 3:30. São 3:30. You can say how many minutes are to the next hour. So 3:45 or a quarter to 4 would be 3:45, 3:45, or quarto para as 4, quarto para as 4. Now, there is a peculiarity of Portuguese, which is you could also say it's 5:15 or it's 5:15. São 5:15. São 5:15. São 5:15. São 5:15. Personally, this form, at least here in the south, seems to be falling a little bit out of use, but I know that up north it's still very much used to this day. Now let's go and practice all of these in this video over here. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you over there. Até já!